Hello, everybody, and welcome back to GT Concept. So, last time on GT Concept, we gotta start with some racing by doing all the normal level events. Now it's time to do some professional races. This time around, they're all three laps, I believe. I mean, I'm gonna do all the difficulty levels, including the hidden ace difficulty level that doesn't actually count towards completion. So, because this game has a lot of cars and a limited track selection, so I figure, why not do them all so I can drive all the cars I want? Anyways, we're starting with midfield, and I already have one car I want have my eyes set on. Gunny's on to C12S 7.3. Because blue. So let's just jump straight into it. XJ220, GT, Volkswagen W12, NSX LM, V8 Vantage. Also, and by the way, this car actually doesn't have a screwed-up transmission like on Gran Turismo 3. Like, this is somewhat usably spaced, even if it's shorter than I expected it would be. Hold on. Oh, I had Steam open. That's messing with the recording because this is my second attempt at recording this because for some reason the recording got stopped even though I didn't really plan to on my first attempt at this. Yeah. I don't know. Steam messes with the controls on the simulator. And it also lets me open up an overlay when I press the pause button, which I don't want. At least I'm not blowing everyone away immediately like before. Sixth gear. This blue Zonda never returned. I mean, C12S 7.3 version did return in later games, but not in blue. This car is not that easy to control. lot more understeer than you might expect. Alright. Let's get... Alright, I get a prize. What do I get? Hello! That's the Spiker C8. Well, I know what I'm driving next race. Under new cars or concepts? Yeah, let's go with black. Oh, yeah, that's a 2 on here. Still got 2 laps to catch up, so... Now, even if I don't, now, well, I probably won't win at this rate, I'll still keep the take. I'll still keep this attempt in, just because I want to show off all the cars that I can, at least. Okay, didn't win, but I'll keep this attempt in because show off the car. And one thing I forgot to mention is that there is actually like a quick tune menu. You can't do much. I mean, you can. I don't know, maybe I'll mess with that at some point. I don't know. Alright, attempt two at this. Let's try. Hey, another car. I'm gonna try this. Yeah, unlike Gran Turismo 4, this thing is actually listed. Not actually as a Cadillac, but it's under GM design. Imagine this thing will blow everyone away much more easily, but you know, since I can mess with the settings, let's see what that. Oh, I don't need to say that. Okay, it does work. Let's go for it. Look at that red line. Oh yeah, this is super short. Yep, out of gears. You're out of speed. Alright. Alright, prize car time. Is what I think it is? Oh, yes. The NSX-LM race car. Motif coloring is based on the NSX or GT1 Turbo. Yeah. So that is the case. Radical C. And then it just. That's the CZ3 tarmac description. Okay. That's a glitch. But yes, I always thought this thing looked like the NSX GT1 Turbo. So that was the point after all. Alright. What can I use for Swiss Alps? Don't really want to use any of those. I mean, I already drove the RSC and the course license, and I've already tried both of those. What can I use off-road? Oh, I can't use the CZ3 Tarmac off-road. What can I use over here? All of these. Well, let's use the air trek. This seems like a reasonable choice. Like I'm fairly evenly matched against the legacy wagon here. Probably could have messed with the settings, but oh well. Like I gotta shorten the gearing probably. Yamaha certainly hold a sizable lead. All right. Show me the money. Oh, yeah, I didn't know this thing from the silhouette. It's the solstice. Car which did eventually make it to production, but only if, but as a convertible, I mean, they did make the coupe, but only briefly. Anyways, time for Tahiti Mace. At least want to keep the cars that weren't in Gran Turismo 3 originally. And stuff that I didn't already use in the Quartz licenses. Alright, let's use this Evo 7. Yeah, it's a wine red metallic. Yeah, this Evo 7 has an automatic transmission. Alright, I am gonna mess with the settings, because why not? Yeah, let's go with that. It's not like I need much around here. And yes, let's slam it for rally racing, because that makes sense. This thing has probably the same transmission as the Air Trek, actually. Because it's a 5-speed that's pretty tall. And I've blown the Impreza away. Kinda not surprised, given that I actually kind of set this car up okay now. Alright. That was easy. Anyways, time for Autumn Ring, I guess. But let's see what I win. Yep. Regular Ford GT. They're still actually going to call it the GT40, but I think it didn't work out because there was somebody selling replicas of the original. I don't know. But I know they were supposed to call it the GT40 and not the GT, but it didn't pan out. Anyways, let's go to Autumn Ring and pick one of these. You know what, let's actually just pick the Ford GTs. Yeah, let's go with the white one. And there's the XJ220 back there. All right. What do I win? Hello. It's a CZ3 rally car. Definitely use that at some point. All right. Tub of yogurt finished. Oh, you can actually choose the accent colors. Because in Gran Turismo 4, you can only go with the red accents. No, I don't need to go in there. Alright, you know what? Since this segment has gone a bit longer than expected, I'm just gonna probably cut the Ace of Professional thing. Original levels into two segments each, just for consistency, so I'm gonna call it for now. Oop. Anyways, thanks for tuning in, and I'll talk to you later. Bye for now!